Raise your right hand and repeat after me.
The Spook Who Sat by the Door, the controversial best-selling novel, now becomes a shocking screen reality. The story of the first black agent in the CIA.
Whoever they select will be the best known spy since 007.
Their first mistake was letting him in.
And let me congratulate you on being the first Negro officer in the Central Intelligence Agency.
Their worst mistake was letting him out.
You really want to mess with Whitey? I can show you.
For 5 years, he was their token Negro.
Freeman, you people must serve.
For 5 years, he kept his cool.
Man, you just don't belong. I think you'd be happier with a mop in your hands.
Like your mama.
And in return, they taught him how to spy. How to fight. How to kill. For 5 years, he was the Spook Who Sat by the Door. And then, he turned gangs of ghetto kids into a highly trained guerrilla army.
We live off the land. We match technology with spontaneity and improvisation. Men against machines, brains against computers. Now, if you don't think it can work, you check out Algeria, Kenya, Korea, and Iran. Can you dig it?
He turned a summer riot into a revolution.
This is not about hate white folks. It's about loving freedom enough to die or kill for it if necessary.
He turned the American dream into a nightmare. Yesterday, a novel. Today, a movie. The Spook Who Sat by the Door.
In Mayor's office, now air conditioned, courtesy of the Black Freedom Fighters of Chicago.
Look. How long since you've been in bed?
Not since the riot started.
That was 3 nights ago, man.
Yeah, I know. Catnap when I can.
When did the National Guard come in?
Late last night. All white.
I noticed.
Yeah, the people didn't dig it when they woke up this morning and found the troops were here.
What do you think they'll do?
I can't see him trying to fight the army.
They didn't mind fighting police?
Yeah. I never seen him like that.
Maybe that badge has put distance between you and them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I forgot. The pigs over here and the people over there. And never the twain shall meet, huh? Hey, man, I grew up down here, too. And I know these people. Now, there were some good people out there in the streets the last few nights. Not just hoodlums, like they say in the newspapers.
In a scene like this, anybody can get involved.
But that's only going to make it worse. We have to maintain law and order, or we might as well be back in the jungle.
Dawes, the ghetto is a jungle, always has been. Understand, you cannot cage people like animals and not expect them to fight back someday. It has always been an army occupation here, with police badges and uniforms. Huh? You and me? Cop and a social worker, we are keepers of this goddamn zoo.
The streets have to be safe.
Safe for who? You're here to protect property, not lives.
Well, that's what it's all about, isn't it? You worked hard to get what you got, didn't you? And you want to keep it just like I do?
Bullshit. Listen, you think because you got a badge and I got a couple of degrees, that makes a difference? Do you know what white folks call people like you and me in private? Niggers, dogs. Niggers.
Hey, hey, hey. Haven't heard you talk like that since we were in college.
Well, I'm sorry, man. Maybe the last 3 nights been a little bit much. I got a board meeting. I got to go reassure the white folks. Let's go get something to eat, okay?
Okay.
And why should you feel threatened by the freedom fighters?
Because I am, and you are too.
How?
You know how. Look, all the progress we've made over the last few years will be wiped out if this thing isn't stopped soon. I heard even your foundation is on its way out.
Well, no. They decided to increase the budget and the staff.
Yeah. Well, my husband was dismissed from the hospital. And he was the first and only Negro on a white hospital staff in the city.
Well, what is the connection between your husband and the freedom fighters?
Damn, that is the whole point! Innocent and decent people are suffering because of niggas who know nothing but hate and revenge.
And it's all the niggas' fault, right?
Look, don't romanticize those people, Dan. They're not beautiful.
Only by contrast.
Damn, those freedom fighters are murderers.
It didn't figure to be long before those niggas realized that you don't have no wind throwing a bat at somebody with a gun.
Dan, whose side are you on?